There, I see it!
Is that finally it? That was a lot of fighting.
Got one! Now I can catch the drone! Could have done better. Can't let any of those bombs explode. Boom goes the dynamite. Better hurry. 10 seconds. Gotta hurry! Just so-so. I hope the psychomaniac doesn't think less of me. Gotta move quick and quiet.
Sharp. Those slackers better not ruin this test.
Hey. You're just not very observant. Gotta move quick and quiet. Aw, they're so cute when they're sleeping.
Hey. Nighty night.
Alright, let's see what this is all about.
Close to perfection.
Just dead.
We're the Magia recruiting big time.
Good night, goon. So cute when they're sleeping.
What's that?
Let's play the quiet game.
The hell was that?
You know my moves! You know I'm gonna wreck you!
Surprise me if you can. Watching you perform my challenges has taught me all your moves.
How about a refresher course? Moves. block if he's incapacitated.
Today we have a caller who's been a victim of what people call the corruption that infects otherwise law-abiding citizens, causing them to go on violent rampages. Police assure me these corrupted are not responsible for their actions, so I am not divulging my guest's name. Tell us, caller, what was it like?
Surreal. Like I was in a nightmare world surrounded by monsters. And every dark impulse I ever had, anger, fear, hate, ramped up and turned loose.
Terrifying. And I understand that while you were in the grip of this madness, Spider-Man beat you up.
Well, he stopped me hurting people.
By beating you up?
I mean, he used as little force as possible.
That sounds like a yes. There you have it, people. Spider-Man beats up the mentally ill.
Hey, sorry I'm late.
Morning, Parker. Or is it evening? That doesn't matter. Okay, then. Check the neurosensors, would you? We need a faster response time.
On it.
Try to get it under 3 milliseconds.
Looks like I could optimize this power relay.
Nice. Okay, what next? Looks like some impedance in this neurosensor circuit. Finished. Signal to noise is out of whack. A new signal processor should reduce lag. I got it, Doc. 2.8 milliseconds.
Good work, Peter.
I call that a mild success.
I call that unbelievable. Do you need some help?
Yes.
Doctor, what's going on?
It's become that obvious. My doctors call it a degenerative neurological disorder. Probably caused by overexposure to toxic chemicals in my reckless youth.
Sorry, is there anything I can do?
You already are. The worst part is, it only affects the muscles. The mind continues to work, but it can no longer do. You're the only one who knows, Peter. I'd like to keep it that way.
Of course.
If you'd like to seek a position with more of a future...
I came here to work for you because of what you've got up here. And that's not going anywhere. So neither am I.
Oh, Peter, before I forget, I read the most fascinating article. Outlines possible next steps for the neural interface.
I'll take a look. Thanks, Doc. Doc loves these things. He used them in grad school when he had to manipulate radioactive isotopes. Says seeing them keeps him humble. What is this, Doc? Never seen this type of material.
Would you believe it's for welding? Provides remarkable magnetic insulation, and limits cross-contamination between the neural interface and arms.
Man, I remember the first day I interviewed here. Showed up with stains on my shirt, 10 minutes late from stopping a mugging. Still can't believe Doc hired me. Hope he doesn't regret it now. Direct interface with the basal ganglia. Exciting, but risky.
I don't know, Doc. You'll need a gallium silk array to make it work. Even then, odds of injury are pretty high.
Gallium! Genius! Never mind the risks. We'll work them out in time.
Doc's really sick. At this rate, he'll lose control of his motor functions within a year. And if we're not careful, an intracranial implant could make things even worse. Even alter his personality. We need to proceed carefully.
Doc, I'm sorry. My aunt just texted.
No worries, Peter. I was thinking of taking a break myself. As soon as I check our telemetry data.
Thanks. I'll be back in a few hours.
Thank you again, Peter. Don't know what I'd do without you.